Hello students, I'm Sai Baba here. So in the previous class I started discussion of the solutions for the questions in the assignment in simple harmonic question. I have discussed the solutions for the questions 1 to 9 in the previous class. So in this class I am going to continue the discussion of the solutions starting from question number 10. Come on, look at the screen here. I am going to read the question number 10 and discuss the solution of this. The particle is moving in a circle of radius Kepler r equal 1 meter with a constant speed v equal 4 meter per second. The ratio of displacement to the acceleration of the foot of the perpendicular dropped from the particle on the diameter of the circle is. So as we discuss here, so as I discussed in the beginning classes in simple harmonic question, if a particle moves in a circular path with uniform speed, that means performing uniform circular motion, then the projection of the particle on one of the diameters of the circle will perform simple harmonic motion. So the radius of the circular path is denoted by Kepler. So if P is the position of the particle at a particular instant moving in the circular path, and let n denote the foot of the perpendicular dropped from the point P on one of the diameters. O is the center of circle. The point P performs uniform circular motion in the anticlockwise direction in the circular path of radius r. The point N, which is the projection of the particle P on one of the diameter, performs simple harmonic motion with amplitude with the displacement amplitude equal to the radius of the circular path. The circular path, we call it as reference circle, circle. So the angular frequency of oscillations for the point N performing SHM along the diameter same as the angular speed of revolution of the particle moving in the circular path. The time period of oscillation for the point N which performs SHM same as the time period of revolution of the particle moving in the circular path. The time period of revolution of the particle moving in the circular path, you can write 2 pi r by v. So you can write v equal to r omega, r omega equal to v by r. V equal to 4 meter per second, r equal to 1 meter, so omega is 4 per second. The acceleration of the point N, put out the perpendicular, let N x denote the instantaneous value of the displacement of the point N with respect to center of circular path measured along the diameter. Then instantaneous acceleration we write minus omega square into x. So x by a will be equal to minus 1 by omega square. So ratio the magnitude of displacement to the acceleration of the point N, which is the foot of the perpendicular dropped from the particle of the diameter circle, will be equal to 1 by omega square, that is 1 by 4 second inverse whole square, so that is 1 by 16 second square. This will be the answer. can want to copy the solution, you can take a pause and copy the solution. So for question number 10, first option is the answer. See the next question, question number 11. A particle starts oscillation, simple harmonically, from its equilibrium position. And the ratio of the kinetic and potential energy of the particle at time capital T by 12 is, assume potential energy is 0 at the mean position. So if you find the ratio of the kinetic and potential of the particle at the given instant of time, you have to know the distance of the particle from the equilibrium position at that instant. So if you start counting time from the instant the particle passes the equilibrium position or mean position in the positive direction, then displacement from mean position at time t is given by x equal to a sin omega t, or you can write y equal to a sin omega t. So t equal to capital T by 12, you can use either letter x or y, any one of the letters to denote the displacement from mean position. So you can write here y equal to a sin, a is the displacement amplitude, omega can be written as 2 pi by capital T. So that is a sin pi by 6, pi radians is 180 degrees. So pi by 6 means 180 degrees by 30 degrees. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. So at the instant, at the given instant, small t equal to capital T by 2, y will be equal to a by 2. It asks you to find the ratio of the kinetic and potential energy of the particle at that instant. If the potential energy is assumed to 0 at the mean position, the potential of the particle at the instant when it is distance y from mean position can be half k y square. And kinetic energy of the particle can be written as half k into a square minus y square. Half k gets cancelled. You substitute y equal to a by 2. Both numerator and denominator. You can, those who want to copy the solution of the problem, they can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem, and please complete the calculation part, simplification part yourself. So for question number 11, second option is the answer. See the next question, question number 12. Two particles execute simple harmonic motion of same amplitude and frequency along close parallel lines. They pass each other moving in opposite directions. Each time their displacement is root 3 by 2 times their amplitude. Their phase difference is, so if you write the displacement from mean position for one of the particles by x1, that is sin omega t, the displacement from mean position for other particle can be the sin omega t plus delta. The delta is the phase difference between the two particles. So at the instant they cross each other, x1 equal x2 equal to a by 2. The two particles cross each other at the instant. The displacement is root 3 by 2 times their amplitude. So at the instant, when they cross each other, at the particular instant, the two particles, they cross each other. X1 equal to x2 equal to a root 3 by 2. Substitute here x1 equal to x2 equal to a root 3 by 2 in the two equations. get sine omega t equal to root 3 by 2. And sine omega t plus delta also root 3 by 2. So consider the first two possible solutions. Of course, sine omega t plus delta is same as sine omega t each equal to root 3 by 2 at the instant across each other. But delta is not 0 because delta will be 0 when the two particles are in the same phase. From the description of the problem, you can see that the two particles are not in the same phase at the instant they cross each other, because it is given that the two particles cross each other each time when the displacement is root 3 by 2 times their amplitude when they are moving in opposite directions. The two particles are moving in opposite directions at the instant they cross each other. So you cannot conclude that they are in the same phase. Therefore, omega t plus delta will be different from omega t. But sin omega t is same as sin omega t plus delta each equal to 3 by 2 at the instant they cross each other. Therefore, we will consider the first two possible solutions for this. As you know, sin 60 degrees was root 3 by 2. And sin 180 minus theta is sin theta. So sin 180 minus 60 is same as sin 60 degrees. That means sin 120 degrees is same as sin 60 degrees each equal to 3 by 2. So if you consider the first solution, the instant they cross each other, we can take sin omega t as 60 degrees, 180 degrees is pi radian. So 1 degree is pi by 180 radians. So 60 degrees will be 60 pi by 180 or pi by 3 radian. So 120 degrees will be 2 pi by 3. Therefore, if we take omega t as pi by 3 at one particular at the instant across each other, omega t plus delta, next solution you can consider 120 degrees or 2 pi by 3. So if you subtract first equation from second equation, so delta you get 2 pi by 3 minus pi by 3. Or pi by 3 radian is the phase difference, or 60 degrees. That's the answer. Those who want to copy the solution, you can take the path and copy the solution. You can also follow another alternate method for this problem, but the alternate method will be more lengthier than this method. For objective type question paper, this method is more convenient or easier. The alternate method is to expand the sin omega t plus delta in the equation. You can write sin omega t cos delta plus cos omega t sin delta. You can substitute the value of sin omega t from first equation. That is equal to root 3 by 2 from this equation into this equation. Then you can solve for delta, you get the same answer. But the procedure is a little bit lengthier. So for question number 12, second option is answer. Then see the next question, question number 13. Block is kept on a rough horizontal plank. The coefficient of friction between the block and the plank is 0.6. The plank is undergoing SHM of angular frequency 10 radian per second in the horizontal direction. The maximum amplitude of the plank with the block does not slip over the plank. This problem comes under one of the special cases which I discussed in the past. Here the restoring force on the plank is equal to the force of static friction. So magnetic restoring force is equal to mass into magnetic acceleration. Magnet of acceleration at an extreme position can be written as omega square root A, where A is the displacement amplitude and omega is angular frequency. M is the mass of the block. So the magnitude of the restoring force on the block at the instant when it reaches one of the extreme positions will be m omega square a. So if the block does not slip on the plank, then the force of friction on the block by the plank can be called as static friction. So magnitude of the static friction is equal to m omega square a at the instant when the block reaches one of its extreme positions. The static friction cannot exceed the limiting value nu s into n because the block is resting on the orient plank and take n equal to mg. Therefore, you can say that block does not slip on the plank if m omega square is less than or equal to nu s into n is mg, or amplitude is less than or equal to nu s into g by omega square. This part of the discussion I have already done one of the special cases. So maximum amplitude which is the block can oscillate, so the platform can oscillate so that the block does not slip, is given by nu s into g by omega square. Here nu s is 0.6, g is given as 10 meter per second square and omega is equal to 10 per second. So therefore maximum value of the amplitude 0.06 meter or 6 centimeter is the answer. So those who want to copy the solution of the problem, they can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So for question number 13, second option is answer. See the question number 14. Block rests on a piston that is moving vertically with simple harmonic motion. The maximum speed of the piston is 2 meter per second. What amplitude of motion will the block and piston separate? This problem also comes under one of special cases I discussed earlier in simple harmonic motion, I think special case 1. So when the block is moving vertically along with the platform, performing simple harmonic motion, the resultant force on the block at any instant will be always directed towards the mean position. Let O be the mean position. At the instant when the block reaches the highest position, the weight mg act toward the mean position normal reaction force on the block by the surface or at the surface of the piston on which it rests acts vertical upwards away from the mean position. Magnitude of the normal reaction, as explained earlier, will be on the block will be minimum at the instant when the block reaches the highest position. So magnitude of the at the highest position, we are considering the highest position where normal reaction is minimum. Magnitude of the resultant force equal to mg minus n. From Newton's second law, that is equal to product of mass into magnitude of acceleration. Resultant force at any instant is always directed towards the mean position in simple harmonic motion. Magnitude of acceleration at one of the extreme positions equal to omega square into a, where a is the displacement amplitude. So the block does not lose contact with the platform when normal reaction is greater than zero. The block remains on the piston, does not lose contact with the piston, or does not lose contact with the oriented surface when normal reaction more than zero. So the block just separates contact with the piston or platform at the highest position when normal reaction becomes zero, or mg minus n is equal to m omega square, n equal to zero. So therefore the amplitude of oscillation at which the block just separates from the piston will be g by omega square. So here you can write omega square A equal to G. Maximum velocity is, in simple harmonic equation, is given by omega into A, that is given to be 2 meter per second. So you use the first and second equations. From first and second equations here, divide first equation with second. Can substitute G equal to 10 meter per second square on the right hand side of the first equation. So you get omega equal to 5 per second. Substitute this value of omega in one of the equations. For example, you can substitute this value of omega in the second equation. So if you substitute this value of omega in second equation, you can find the amplitude of oscillate with the block get separated from the piston, that comes out to be 2 by 5.4 meter or 40 centimeters. Those who want to copy the solution of the problem, they can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. Fourteenth question, third option, 40 centimeters. See the question number 15 then. Particle is performing simple harmonic motion along x-axis with amplitude 6 centimeters and time period 1.5 seconds. The minimum time taken by the particle to move from x equal plus 3 centimeter to plus 6 centimeters and back again is given by. So here the amplitude of oscillations is given to be 6 centimeters and the time interval of oscillation is 1.5 seconds. From that you can find omega. So omega is equal to angular frequency of oscillation, 2 pi by time period. So 2 pi by 1.5 seconds. So that will be 4 pi by 3 per second. You are asked to find minimum time taken by the particle to move. Let O be the mean position at its x is 0. And that one of the extreme positions x equal to plus A. Or that is plus 6 centimeters. At which velocity is 0. Let P be the point in the circular path at which x becomes equal to plus 3 centimeters. So we start counting time when the particle crosses the mean position in the positive direction at t equal to 0. Let t equal to t1 represent the first instant of time. The particle is found at the point P. So the time taken with particle to move from mean position to one of the extreme positions, as already discussed, will be equal to 1/4 of the time period. The time taken with the particle to move from mean position to one of the extreme positions. So the time taken with the particle to move from P to A will be the time T by time taken to move from O to the extreme position. Let us denote extreme position by E. O to E minus O to P. That is T by 4 minus T1. To find the time taken with the particle to move from P to the extreme position, then back to same point P. So we start timing when the particle is initial at the mean position. Displacement from mean position at time t is given by x equal to sin omega t. So x equal to at t equal to t1 in time, x is 3 centimeters. Amplitude is here 6 centimeters. साइन ओमेगा इंटू टी वन, द साइन ओमेगा टी वन इज इक्वल टू 3/6 और 1/2, साइन 30 डिग्री इज 1/2, सो 30 डिग्री इन रेडियन विल बी पाई बाई सिक्स, एंड दिस ओमेगा यू कैन राइट 2 पाई बाई कैपिटल टी. So T1 can be written as capital T by 12. So the time taken by the particle to move from point P to one of the extreme positions is equal time taken to move from mean position to one of the extreme position, that is T by 4 minus T1. T1 is the time taken to move from O to P. So time taken to move from P to A can be written as time taken to move from mean position O to one of the extreme positions minus time taken to move from O to P. That is T by 4 minus T1, that is T by 4 minus T by 12, that is T by 6. So you are asked to find time taken to move from P to extreme position and then back to same position. So that means the time taken to move from P to E and back to P can be taken as time taken to move from P to E is T by 6. It can be shown that it takes same time T by 6 to move from E to P. So that will be T by 3. So the time period 1.5 seconds. So that will 0.5 seconds. So answer is 0.5 seconds. Some of the students make it a doubt how the time taken to travel back from E to P is also T by. Here we have shown the time taken to move from P to E is T by 6. It can be shown that time taken to move from E to P is also T by 6. To show that time taken to travel from E to P is also T by 6, you can start timing when the particle is at the positive extreme position. As explained in the past, if you start counting time from the instant when the particle is initially at the positive extreme position, then displacement from mean position at time t is given by x equal to a cos omega t. Then if you take x equal to 3 and a equal to 6 centimeters, and you get cos omega t, of course problem is completed with this step. This working I am doing only to convince you that the time taken to move from extreme position to the point P is also T by 6. So this is not the solution of the problem. This is only additional discussion beyond the solution of the problem. So if you start counting time when the particle is at positive extreme position, that means if the particle is initially at the positive extreme position, that time displacement at time T measured from mean position is given by x equal to a cos omega t. So you have to find the time taken to move from extreme position to the point P. So at point P you can take x equal to 3 centimeters. A is 6 centimeters. So cos omega t you get 1/2. So omega t you get pi by 3. Cos 60 degrees pi by 3. So you get time taken to move from extreme position to the point P can also be, you should substitute omega equal to 2 pi by capital T on the left hand side. You get time taken to move from extreme position to the point P is also T by 6. So those who want to copy the solution of the problem, they can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So for question number 15, second option is the answer. Next is the question number 16. Particle vibrates In simple harmonic motion along a straight line, its greatest acceleration is 5 pi square centimeter per second square. And when it is distance from the equilibrium point is 4 centimeter, the velocity of the particle is 3 pi centimeter per second. The amplitude and period of oscillation of the vibrating particle are the greatest acceleration or maximum acceleration of a particle performing SHM will be equal to omega square into A, where omega is angular frequency and capital A is the magnitude of displacement amplitude, which is given to be 5 pi square centimeter per second square. This is given as the problem. And it is given that when displacement from mean perturbation denoted by y is 4 centimeter, the magnetic velocity v equal to 3 pi centimeter per second. The magnetic velocity of the particle performing SHM at the instant when it is a distance y from mean position is given by v equal to omega at root of s square minus y square. So to eliminate omega square from first and second equation, we can square both sides. So we can substitute here v equal to 3 pi centimeter per second on the left hand side. When displacement y from mean position is 4 centimeter, that means here we have expressed all units in the serial system. So if you square both sides of this equation, you get omega square into a square minus 16 square centimeter equal to 9 pi square. Centimeter square per second square. So as square both sides, square root will go. Then you divide the second equation with first equation, or first equation with second equation. Divide the first equation with second equation. For all units are understood to be the CGS system here. Is equal to 5 pi square by 9 pi square. Omega square gets cancelled left side. Pi square gets cancelled right side. So cross multiply and square both sides. Cross multiply both and solve for amplitude. Here A is the magnitude of displacement amplitude. So those who want to copy the solution of the problem, they can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. And I advise you to take the pause and complete the calculation part yourself. You can solve for A, consider the positive value of A. Here A represents the magnitude of displacement amplitude. And after calculating the value, subtract the value of A in one of the equations. In the first equation, to find omega, from omega you can find time period. So you can solve this equation by factorization. As a minus 9A, you can write minus 25A plus 16A. Then you can take 5A common on the first two terms on the right side and 16 common on the right second last two terms on the right side. Then you take A minus 5 common. So in product of two factors, one of the factors is must be 0. So you consider positive value of A, you will get 5 centimeters. That is one of the answers. Substitute the value of A in the first equation to find the value of omega square. So from first equation, you can write omega square into A is 5 centimeters. Is equal to 5 pi square. So we get omega equal to pi per second. So the time period of path ratio you can write 2 pi by omega or 2 pi by pi, or 2 seconds will be the answer for time period. Those who want to copy the solution of the problem, they can take a pause and complete writing the solution of the problem. So for question number 16, second option is answer. See the next question here. Question number 17. I am going to discuss the question number 17. A particle executes simple harmonic motion with amplitude 5 cm. The distance of 3 cm from mean question, magnitude, the velocity and acceleration are numerically equal. The period of oscillations. So magnitude of the acceleration is omega square into y. And magnitude of the velocity can add omega into root of a square. Magnitude of the velocity of the particle is such m can be written as omega into root of a square minus y square. And magnitude of the acceleration, omega square into magnitude of the displacement from mean position. So given that amplitude of oscillator 5 centimeters and at y equal to 3 centimeter, magnitude of velocity is same as magnitude of acceleration. You can equate these two. So magnitude of velocity is equal to omega into root of a square. A can be written as 5 centimeters. Y equal to 3 centimeters. Let us follow completely CGS units here. Right side, that is omega square into y, magnitude of displacement y 3. So from this you get the value of omega. So omega you get 4 by 3 per second. So the time period of oscillation is given by 2 pi by omega, or 2 pi by 4 by 3 per second. So our time period of oscillations will be 3 pi by 2 seconds. If you want to copy the solution, you can take a pause and copy the solution. So for question number 17, third option is the answer. Then you see the next question here, question number 18. This similar problem I have discussed earlier, which comes in one of special cases. Lock is on a oriented surface which is moving orientally with a simple harmonic motion of period 5 seconds. The greatest amplitude of block, so the block does not slip, is 4.9 centimeters. The coefficient of friction between the block and surface. As explained, one of the problems I discussed in the same case. In this same class, the block does not slip if the magnetic steering force at the extreme position does not exceed the limiting friction nu s into mg. So the maximum value of the amplitude for which the block does not slip on the platform will be nu s into g by omega square. So maximum value of amplitude is given to 4.9 centimeters, that is 4.9 into 10 power minus 2. G is given to 9.8 meter per second square. Omega is equal to 2 pi by time period. So the time period is given to be pi seconds. So omega I can write 2 per second. From this you can find the value of nu s. So you get nu s equal to 0.02. So that will be the answer. So for question number 18, third option is answer. Then see the question number 19. E is the total energy, F is the maximum force acting on the particle, and capital T is the time period of oscillation in simple harmonic motion. The maximum velocity of the particle is, assume potential energy is 0 at the mean position. So if the potential energy is 0 at the mean position, then the total energy of oscillation, same as the maximum value of kinetic energy, that is equal to half into mass on the square of the maximum velocity. That is half m omega square a square. And maximum value of the force is equal to mass into magnitude of maximum value of acceleration. Maximum value of acceleration is omega square into a. And omega you can write 2 pi by time period. So you can divide the first equation with second equation to find amplitude in terms of E and F. So the mass M gets cancelled here. Omega square also gets cancelled. So you get half E on the right side, equal to E by F. So the magnitude of displacement amplitude can be written as 2E by F. So maximum velocity of the particle in a system can be written as omega into A. Omega you can write 2 pi by time period. Amplitude is 2E by F. So 4 pi E by F into T. So you can also write pi equal to 22 by 7. So you get 88 E by 7 FT. Those who want to copy the solution of the problem, they can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So for question number 19, first option is answer. See the question number 20. Particle of mass 10 gram is performing simple harmonic motion with a frequency of 10 per second. The maximum speed during the oscillations is 4 centimeter per second. The total energy of oscillations is, assuming potential energy is 0 at the mean. So if the potential energy at the mean point, which is not by U0, is 0, then the total energy of oscillations, same as the maximum value of kinetic energy at the mean position, that is equal to half into mass into square of the maximum velocity. The mass m is given to be 10 gram. Maximum velocity is given to be 4 centimeter per second. That's the answer for the question number 20. We are given the frequency also, but that's not needed to answer the given question. Of course, some of the students may try to solve the problem by first finding omega, then using the parallel half m omega square, then also you get the same answer. But this is the easier way you can do it. The frequency is given at 10 per second, maximum velocity is a omega, that is 4 centimeter per second. So omega can be just 2 pi times frequency, that is 2 pi into 10. From that you can find amplitude. After calculating amplitude, then you can also use the equation half m omega square a square. But that calculation will be more tedious, but you get the same answer even by that method also. But this is easier method. So for question number 20, second option is the answer. See the question number 21. Body of mass 0.1 kg performing simple harmonic motion with a frequency of 35 by 11 per second and amplitude 0.1 meter. These oscillations are produced by spring. Then the force constant of the spring is equal to. So the mass of the oscillating body is given to 0.1 kg. The frequency of oscillations is the reciprocal of the time period of oscillation, that is equal to 35 by 11 per second. The amplitude is also given, but time period is independent of amplitude. So time period of spring mass system, as I explained earlier, we given 2 point root of m by k, which is reciprocal of frequency. So frequency of oscillations can be written as 1 by 2 pi root of k by m. Then substitute here frequency n equal to 35 by 11. So 1 by 2 pi. Pi you can write 22 by 7. K by m is equal to 0.1 kg. So you can copy down this. If you can take a pause and copy down the working, if you want to copy the solution, and please try to complete the calculation part so all units are SI system, so you'll get right side 10k. Can cancel some common factor here, so you get 20 on the left side, that you square both sides. So finally you get the answer as 40 newton per meter. Those who want to copy the solution of the problem, then take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So for question number 21, second option is answer. So I will be continuing the solutions of the remaining 9 questions in the assignment in my next class.